Hello, 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 and welcome to my latest video. Well, I say latest, this was done a while ago. Sorry I haven't been releasing videos. I haven't had the time in my non-work life to go through and edit, which means I have a pile of a lot of videos because I've been carrying on doing the art, just not having the time for the videos. This is going to be blurry for a minute, but it will correct itself. This is a wave. This is the second rainbow wave that I've done, but this time including pink as well as the purple. I think I also had a turquoise in here, so it's the original Gilbert Baker colours. But we shall see as I go through. It's a while since I actually recorded this. So there's the very bright pink going on. Top colour there. And then coming in with one of the purple. Just stick with me, guys. The blurring will sort itself out in about 10 seconds. I almost abandoned recording this video because of that. Oh, there we go. There's a metallic purple going in on top of the normal purple. And then a blue and some silver coming in. I wanted this to be everything to pop a little bit more, so I've used quite a bit of silver as I've gone through. And there's the metallic turquoise. Coming in, and a green blue there, and there's the pebeo yellow green. So I think that was pebeo blue green, green blue, yellow green. That's just yellow, and this is the pebeo iridescent orange. And the pink, I think, was permanent rose. And at this point, I just remembered I hadn't been putting the colours in on the crest of the wave. I do that every time. And that one is a pebeo blue-red. I don't know why it's blue-red. There's very little blue in it. And just coming in with a darker red there. And some more dark red coming in on the sides. And remembering that I meant to put silver in between every other layer, I just go in and I've put it in there. And because I know the colour that I want the edge to be, I'm now just finger painting in the colour red, because I didn't want all of this to go so far going over the edge, so I've just finger painted the colours in. There's a lot of paint on the canvas, but in theory it won't always go right up to the edge, and I was experimenting with this one with the idea of just having the colours as you can see in the layers that they are, and then having the rest of it kind of finger painted on, so it's not necessarily going to go over the edge. It's kind of an experimental bit designing how it's going to go out. And I'm putting some white in just to help the colours show up a little bit more, and then putting some more pink to the edge, because I'm worried at this point that the colours are not going to come out as much as I want. So now with the blowout, you notice that I'm just blowing the first two colours in. The technique that I've developed for the ocean wave, the one that works for me, is the first two colours blow them in towards the negative space in the middle, and then the next little bit of colour blow over each other, then blow out the rest of them towards the edge of the canvas, and then come over afterwards to get your proper big tie-dye-ish effect. Is how I tend to do it, because I want it to, when I'm doing the rainbow waves, and I've done a fair few of these off camera as well, I just want the colours really to pop, but altogether the rainbow palette can muddy badly. That's one of the reasons why I have quite so much silver when I do some of these pieces. Just because that can act as a barrier colour and help a little bit. As usual, I'm messing up the crest of the wave there. Trying to make it work with some finger painting some details in. But it just has not worked. So I'm coming in with some more of the colours that I want to be seeing in there, and I'm going to take another attempt at getting the colours there, just because it's diluted a little bit too much with the white. So coming back in with the, there we go. Looks amazing. Oh shit, there's the white. There we go. Coming back in with the colours again. And seeing if I can get it to work how I want. And it's not. So I'm taking the decision at this point to come in with a tissue just to take some of the colour off and put a bit more of some other colours in, just so that it looks a bit more deliberate with how it's gonna turn out. And there we go. I'm assessing, looking, seeing if I like the overall composition or not. This point, I'm also putting some stuff on the edge, because where I had to do the thing, I leant over the canvas and got a load of paint on my shirt. Which meant that the edge looked very dodgy. In fact, I'm pretty sure at this point I'm doing that again. Number of t-shirts that I've managed to ruin with this, but there we go. And just tried blowing out a little bit more just to get that last bit done. And the crest of the wave is always the bit that I struggle with getting to work just right, particularly on the rainbow blowouts, because I really want all of the colours to show on the crest. And yeah, sometimes that doesn't quite work quite as much as I want. Coming in there with the straw, it's the thing that I would always suggest you do last. Go in with a straw just to blow some of your top colours out, just to give you the, for it to show a bit more that you've got the turbulence of the water in there. But thank you for watching. Please like, subscribe, and there are going to be a lot more of these coming out, because I have so many videos to release. Speak soon. Bye-bye.